Hi, my name is Pastor Xola Jones Nzo. I was born in Daveyton in South Africa. We could safely say our church is not only a church, it's a community center. People come here for all kinds of needs. We are in a major drive to start a lot of other churches next year, and we're starting 11 churches at one time. We've got 9 now, and we're going to 11. And my dream is that when I'm 1060, we have 2,000 churches. Pray with me. You might think it's an impossibility, but all things are possible with God. What is impossible with man is possible with God. It's not an ambition, but it is belief. It's doable, and I believe God for it. Somebody said, when a gift becomes a skill, everything becomes easy. So one of the major things we had to do upfront and laying the foundation was to decide our values, who we are, because very values decide who you are. Of course, values feed into principles by which you run the church, and principles are the founding blocks of any ministry. And if we were to, you know, employ the words of Jesus, that Jesus says, if anything is founded upon the rock of doing his sayings, it will last longer. And we celebrate the goodness of God that after 19 years of existence, and we're still strong. One of the values that we have to decide is to live right, is to be a church that is known for holiness. I listened to a man of God who was teaching. His name is Bishop Tudor Bismarck. He said something very profound. This is what he says. He says, as a leader, you've got to decide how you want and wish to be known. So you decide how you want to be known, and in terms of your reputation and what do you allow, you know, into the congregation. You allow lightness, looseness, and whether you allow depth and holiness and cleanliness. So number one, we're not legalistic, but we believe in living right. Number two, another value that we espouse is, of course, is making sure that people live by principles, that, you know, we win people, we grow them out of, depending on the people. We teach people to work for themselves, and we develop a culture of hard work, and I'm an example to that. And then we teach our young people to be involved in business at a younger age, and to run their own things, to study, and to use their creativity, to bless their creativity. Because if you don't do that, what's going to happen? You're going to develop a breed of young people who love Jesus, but who are social misfits and who do not fit socially in terms of making sure they work for themselves, they're competent in the housing market, in the car buying market, and sometimes it's establishing families. They establish anomalies. So it's very important that we teach them that. But some of the things that I teach hard about is making sure that we believe in prayer. Prayer is a primary substance of what we do. We pray for everything. We bring every decision to the Lord in prayer. Another value, of course, we believe that we are a church that is placed by God, planted by God in this community to minister to everybody. One of the things we've seen is that since we believe in excellence, and one of the major pillars of our church is excellence. Excellence, of course, it's not an event, it's a way of life. Excellence is refusing to settle for less. Beyond good comes excellence. Excellence is expensive. Effectiveness is the entry into this game where you're going to run a mega church like we do. But greatness is what keeps you at the top. What we have seen as a net result is that churches in our city, they've raised the bar because they come here. Every year we have a conference because God has placed us here, you know, to minister to everybody that is here. We run a social program. We believe in uplifting, social upliftment. Thank you for being part of us. And we love you as you're interacting with this a medium of expression and this medium. And we love you very much. And may God bless you.